So today in this class, I have we have discussed about the range object in the VBA Micro programming. So range, if you want to select the A1, B1, any range, so how can call the range just like seat and workbook? So we have discussed the first. I have cleaned the micro now. So discuss.
Chachi.
Yeah, right.
Whenever I open my Excel sheet, VB macros, previously I recorded some macros, it will be there. How can I remove that recorded macros?
Okay, just delete the code.
That's it, huh?
Otherwise you can also wear the macros, select and delete here.
Whenever just deleted and whenever again I am open another Excel also, that code is there.
No. Okay, I think you have recorded the personal micro, right?
Yes.
Yeah, personal micro have a problem. For the personal micro, delete the code just.
Mm-hmm.
Your micro will be removed.
Okay.
So we have start here the code. If you want to call the range, we have the two methods for the call range. First range, enter here the address is just like A1, V1, C1 dot select. Second, in the cells, write the row and number. This is the R1, C1 reference style, A1 row and one column dot select. Another method. Second is the active cell. If your seat cell will be activated, you can call. And second is the fourth is the selection. Selection active cell is the one cell because I have select the D12F4. So D1 is the active cell. I have typed any value to the type in the D1, but selection is the D12F14. So if you call to selected area, to go with the selections, active cell, then just active cell. And if you have the row and column in the numbers, just like R1, C1 in style, this is important because in future you have just matched data and get the row numbers in the row and in the numbers and column in the numbers, then use this cell program. And you have the numbers just like A1, B1, C1, alphanumeric, then use the range. This is the four method for the calling range. So first discuss the today selection. How can select the data? Because selection is the very important part, because if you want to apply anything in the Excel, need to selection. Just like you want to start the pivot, also want to selection. You want to filter, also want to selection. You want to copy, also want to selections. So selection, first the select the data and next apply any features in the Excel. So selection is important. So how can select the data and how can select the dynamic data in the VBA programming? So I want to select, you have a selection that is normally type here A1 to H11. So right here, range A1 to H11 dot select. But you have select to sheet one, and your sheet will be activated. Then this code will work. But if you have the sheet two and run this code, then the C2 H11 will be selected. But I have any seat activated, but I want to select the data of C2 1. So before this code, you have right here code the activated seat. Is seat 1 dot select. So first activate the sheet and then select your data. But this work for the active file. But you have the open the two file, this, let's say book one and book two, and you want to go with book one and sheet one and then select the data, then that time you have also need to go right here. Work books, or here is the book one dot xlsx dot select. Right? No, sorry, ma'am. This is activate. Now, first activate the book, then activate the sheet, and then select the data.
Sarji, workbooks dot book one dot xlx dot worksheet. Just worksheet.
No. First activate your sheet. A file, then okay. Activate yourself because you can manually you can go direct go to the sheet one. No, first go to the file, then go to the sheet one.
Yes.
So this is a step by step. One line, one action. Do you remember every time? One line, one action.
Okay.
So, here is the data. I want to select the data. I have the another way to select it. This selection like the Excel. Sorry. So right here another way, range A1 comma H11 dot select. This is the VBA way. This is the starting part or this is the ending part, right? So with VBA do, click on the this cells and press the shift, click on the last cell. Your data will be selected. So this code is the Excel method, and this code is the VBA method, because when you want to select the dynamic selection, then use this code. But manual selection you can use this code. Okay, and I want to select the multiple cells, just like press the control and select the this tab, the selections, multiple cells. That time use the range inverted comma A1 comma C1 comma D1 comma is right there and select. In the inverted comma is use the write the code with separate with the comma. Okay. And now I want to select the control A, just like all data. Control A, just like all data. So write the code here, because you have remember I first class we discussed about that in the Excel have a go to a special and current region. Current region, it means select all. So right here, range, the starting of the data, dot,
current region,
dot select. Your data, a control A, your current region, your all data selected. But do you want to select the all sheets, the entire sheets? Every sales, then use the sales, then select. So you have write the code sales dot select. It means select the complete sheet. Click here, triangle. Select the entire sheet. Okay. And now I want to move our cursors. Just like I have my cursor here, and when the user press the control and press the down arrow key, our cursor will go to the last of the data. As per sequence, series, if your series will be blank here, so that time our data stop here. So I want control and down arrow. So we when you use the control down arrow, our cursor go to the last. Right arrow, right last, up arrow, up last, left, left last. Right? So how can we move that? So right here, range, A1, the starting of our data, dot and. And we have the arrow key. Excel down, Excel shift, Excel right, left, up. Which ones we want to go down? Select here and select it. Okay.
Okay.
Your cursor will select the A1 and press the control down arrow. Your cursor will be last of the data. But I want to go to the last of the data. But problem is that my data have a blank row, blank cells. So when you use the this facility control and page down arrow, our cursor the next breakable series before of the blank cells. This is the problem. So I want to go to the last data. So I have go to the last sale, just like a 65,000, and you can write also the 10 lakhs. And after then, press the control up arrow. So our cursor go to the down, go to the last data. If your data will be blank, not consider that. How can I write the code? So right here, range A65,000 dot and XLS up dot select. Right, sir?
Okay, 65,000 means?
See, you can also write the 10 lakh here, the last row of the your last row of your seats.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is the last row of the seats. 10,40,000. Also right here, but I have write that 65,000 around, because if you this micro run with the your older version, it's like 2013, that have the error in the code, because 2013 not have that more than 65,000 row.
Why don't you use a comma a?
Yeah, you can ask this. Hello?
A comma A.
This is A 65,000 row. Okay. I have go to the last cell. You can also write the 10 lakh. Right, sir? And after then we have pressed the control up arrow, then our cursor go to the last cell of the last cell of the data. Right, sir? So I have also write here 10 lakhs, the last the address of the row, last row.
Mm-hmm.
But problem is that if you run this macro to our older version, just like .xls file, Excel 2013 version, where you get the problem, because in the 2013.xls file, not have less than 65,000 row, not have more than 65,000. If you that time run, then you can get the error, because 10 lakh cell address not available in the 2013 and the 2003 and older version. So we have write the 60,000, but your data will be more than 65,000, then you can write the your according to a 5 lakh, a 6 lakh, a 10 lakh, anything the maximum row. Okay, and press the and an Excel up, you go to the last row of the data, So we can, why use this line of the code? Because my data have a blank row, right, sir?
Mm-hmm.
When you use the control down, our data, our cursor not go to the last row, either stop the before of the blank cell.
Mm-hmm.
So that time we have used the go to the down and go to the up, then go to the last cell. Clear?
Clear.
Okay. But I want to select with selections. I go to the cursor last cell with selection. This is a control shift down. It's like a left. I want to when you place the control down arrow, cursor go to the last cell. But when you place the control shift down arrow, then your cursor go to the down but select with selection.
Hmm.
That time we have used here code range A1, the starting position. We have used this method. Is the starting or this is the ending? So A1 is the starting part or ending part is the A1 dot and XLS down dot select. So the first click here. And second, go to the last and click here. Your data will be selected. Now this is the I have merged one code into another code because this code is the individual. So this code I have replaced. This code I have replaced from the your last cell. It's like here is the A1 to H1. So I have copied the code and replaced here. So we have merged one code in the another code. Why? Because we have, I want to the run two step in the one line.
Mm-hmm.
So right here we have merged the code. So first select the A1 and go to the last cell and then select, then give the selections. So you can also write here, just like I want to selection like that, control shift right arrow and down arrow. So place here range A1 range A1 dot and Excel to right dot select. And now we have write the range starting the selection. Selection on selection dot and Excel down dot select. Yeah, I have write the two line of code. First line select your data like that, and second line this selection. Continue do the selection, continue with down. Your data will be selected. So the problem is that why use this code? Because I have the control A command, select the alt. So why not use the control A? Just like current region. Right, sir?
Yeah.
Current is the simple compare than this code.
Yes.
With current region have a one problem. I have write the some unnecessary data here. Right, sir?
Mm.
Control A select the also this unnecessary data. So do you have want to select only for data, then you can use this code. But again, problem here, if your data have a blank row like that, blank column also, that time this code select only for this data, not all data. So I want to select the all data. How can? So we use the another method here.
Under.
No, just listen. I have apply the variables here. See, range xfd1 dot and is the excel2lab dot column. So this code, go to the last column of the data. Last column is name is xfd1, right, sir? And after then, press the control right, left arrow and go to the last column of your data and pick the column number and store on the C. It is clear? And like that, we have used the code for range, row. So right here, last sale of the data, just like A65,000, you can also write the 10 lakh, 20 lakh. So 10 lakh and 5 lakh as per your requirement. Then and Excel up dot row. So this code, go to the last sale of your data, A65,000 and A10 lakh. And press the up arrow, go to the upper cell of last row of your data and pick the row number and store on the R. So we have the column number and also the column row, row number. But problem is that our row number and our row and column in the number format. So we have used the cell for the if you row and column in the number, you can use the cells. So I want to select the data. So right here, starting the data, our starting data is the A1, and right here sales, and in the sales, R is the row and C is the column. Dot select. So this is the dynamic selection. If your data have any blanks, your data will be selected. Okay, sir.
Okay.
Clear?
Okay.
This is a selection method. So practice this data, and tomorrow we discuss the one project around on the range.
Okay. Share this video.
Yeah, I have convert the video and share. And any doubts from the last classes?
Yeah. Wait.
Tell you. Okay. Okay, see you tomorrow, same time.
One second. I have one doubt.